gift of gathering and recognize the gift of peace that comes with your truth being exposed and responding in worship and repenting so that we can't even respond in worship. So we recognize your peace. We've experienced your peace. And now we know because you are the God of mission. We know that you are now commissioning us to leave this place. You are commissioning us. You are sending us as your ambassador, sending us as your clear living message to proclaim your message, to proclaim your truth. To so to speak our Nineveh, to those who desperately need you, who are lost, who are wicked. Father, you've chosen us to participate. You've invited us to be a part of your movement of mission. So Father, we choose that road that goes to someone. We choose that road that ultimately leads to you. So we love you. You guys thank Ethan and Joey and Liz. Thank you so much. We can go do this enough. So, hey, can you guys give our tech group, can you guys give them a hand and thank them for it? Guys, thank you so much for being here week out. And by the way, that is the way that they worship. And so they're with us providing us an opportunity and an atmosphere, a texture, and an environment to do that. So make sure you guys thank them. Make sure you guys know Ethan ultimately oversees that here with Bryce. So make sure you guys thank them all for that. Make sure you thank Joey, Ethan, and Liz for hanging with us tonight. So love you guys. And we've got some announcements coming up in the next couple weeks for you. So I want to encourage you to stay connected, be here. A couple of announcements are extraordinarily important to hear. But also, listen, this is an incredible story. It's beautiful yet tragic in a whole lot of ways. And so just stay along with us. This first week was the first one that was we're gonna go through the smallest passage of scripture. It was the most nuanced, it was the most that we needed to unearth from there. We'll finish out chapter one and then we'll just do chapter two in a week, chapter three in a week, and chapter four in a week, 10, 10, 11. So make sure you guys are here for that. Come back if you're gonna be gone, in case you want the podcast to be up. So check back at that regularly. Make sure you bring some people with you. We love you guys. I believe in you, not because of who you are, but because of Christ and the gospel of the Lord and living in you. So we love you. You're dismissed. We'll see you guys next week. Thanks for hanging.
Story in here. Father, as Maddie's community, as the gift.
gather with the call out ones that you've called us, that you've assembled here, just week in and week out, Father, we've got a responsibility to sojourn with her, to walk alongside with her, to create a place and a home for her, that to create an opportunity for her to lean into us, to create an opportunity for her to find some solace and some refuge. So, Father, I pray for the Steiner family. Lord, I pray not for distance, because distance creates confusion. Distance creates isolation. Father, instead, Lord, I pray for closeness. Lord, I pray that you continue to draw them closer to you, Father, when we know that you're pursuing their hearts. Father, just as you sent mighty wind in a strong, violent storm to remind children that you are pursuing, Father, oftentimes you allow things. But Father, even in the midst of this storm for the Steiners, we still know that you are there also. Father, we know that this is good because you are good. So as Lord, we pray for your mercy and for your grace over that family. Father, thanks for allowing us to experience again this beautiful story that you have somewhere in here for the, for that family, and ultimately for your kingdom and for your glory and for your honor, Lord. Lord, this will make you look beautiful somehow, some way. So God, thanks for allowing us to experience it. We love you for speaking prayer. Amen. Make sure you guys stick along with Maddie and support her, love her, keep praying for her. So love you guys, we'll be dismissed.